Parshat Nasso, Yair and Tanya, the learning should be the Refuat Kol HaCholim, ובתוכם Tanya בת הודה מגלית, יוסף יער בן ריבה חווה, הרב סימן בן סימה, בתוך כל שאר חולי ישראל. We have the blessing, this Parsha, to address our schools together, me and Tanya. So I'll do my best to present a question on our Parsha, and then we'll have the answer from Tanya, Bezot Hashem. The beginning of Sefer Bamidbar, in the first prakim, describes the journey of taking the nation from the desert into the land of Israel. And it goes through different levels and layers of how we build the structure of the nation of Israel. And so it starts off by describing each tribe on its own and giving the description of the nation and how each individual is part of the circle. From then we go to the level of the leadership, the Levim, the people that are going to lead and guide the nation. And then we get to what seems to be the ending, which is the Mishkan, the spiritual guidance of the camp of Israel. The problem is that when we look in our Parsha, in Perek Hei, the Torah describes a new layer. And the last layer, the next layer, says, "Vayidaber Hashem al Moshe le'emor, tzav b'nei Yisrael v'yishlechu min ha'machaneh kol tzaro v'chol zav," describing that once we've already described all the different levels, we speak about the fact that the last thing is to realize that there are certain people that cannot walk with the nation. And the question that me and Tanya were thinking together was, why is this the climax of structuring Am Yisrael as they enter into Eretz Yisrael? Meaning, why is it important that we have this extra layer at the end, once we thought we've accomplished all the circles, to say to us, but don't forget, there's another section, another level of the journey to realize those who cannot be part of the journey on every single day. So that would be our question, and I'm going to pass it to Tanya Bezat Hashem to reveal the answer.
Thank you, Yair. So obviously there can be many answers. We have many commentators, but Yair and I, mainly Yair, thought of an answer that I definitely agree with. So we were asking this question of the differences, the different stages within us understanding our preparation into getting into the land of Israel. We're speaking about the Am Yisrael, we're speaking about the leaders, and we're speaking about the situation, the position of the Mishkan, and how we would move it if we needed to, and when we needed to. So, and the peak, we talk about these people that cannot be included within the nation. And I think, and we think, we thought that that really, when building a structure, when building any structure, and if we bring it to our lives, our own personal lives, when we build a community, when we build a school, when we build any structure or system, we have all these different details that we need to take care of. We have to take care of the students, we have to take care of the teachers, we have to take care of the building itself, where we're going to put the Beis Midrash, where we're going to put the classrooms, where's the rabbi going to live, if he's going to live close to the shul. All these things are details that are essential in building a community and building a structure, a successful structure. Comes HaKadosh Baruch Hu, comes the Torah and tells us maybe a very special and important message. And we have to remember that within the sequence of the Dvarim, of these parashiyot, this is the peak, okay? And it tells us this important lesson. These people that are on the outskirts of the community, on the outskirts of our school, these people are essential and important to take note of, and even maybe more fundamental and more important than everything else, all the details within the structure. Meaning, all these people that might not be included, we need to find ways to have them included within us. And I think that the school itself, specifically the school and the community, but the school itself takes that as one of its
models.
Yeah, one of its models and one of its proud fundamentals. I think no one can remember one a speech of Rabbi Grauer's where he says when people ask him what's the typical type of student that comes to either Orach Chaim or Ulpana, he says that the typical student is atypical because so much individuality is formed in the school. Each student is seen as an individual. Each student is cared for as an individual with special care and inclusive care, and I see that throughout the school. I see that with the way that they're enabling all the educators to work in a very different and personal way to them. You could have some, you know, loud educators. You could have some, you know, quiet or intense or spiritual or motivating, whatever it is. Very special and unique to the school. In terms of the community, I found the same idea, and personally I could speak about it. From the moment we got here, we had so much care, and I felt embraced by the community, and I felt that specifically also when we ourselves had a beautiful simcha in our lives, but it was also merged with hardship when we had Ronnie, our little daughter, and the community really embraced us, from bringing us meals, caring for us, phone calls, messaging, and it's not once, not twice, three, four, five times people would bring us meals and continuously try to make sure we were okay with whatever we needed, and it was really, really phenomenal to see. I think we all, and Baruch Hashem, in the Jewish community, are involved in really good things. Each of us, whether it is in the, you know, surgical room or in the classroom, we're saving lives, we're doing good things. But Judaism, the Torah, comes to tell us it's not only about the details within the communities, it's about the details that are without the community. The people that we don't necessarily see at shul, the people that have stopped coming to shul, for whatever reason, either religiously, mentally, physically, for whatever reason, those are the people we have to notice, those are the people we have to look out for, because if we don't, then the whole system that we've built might be flawed.
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.